But today we are going to cover one last thing in chapter 4. And then we're going to talk about the exam. And if you want, you can ask me questions about previous semester's exams. Okay? So that's what we're going to do today. Any questions before we start? You get your homework here. I will try to get it done, and I probably will just leave it outside my office door either Friday night or Saturday morning or something like that, so you can come and get it sometime.
Will you email us when it's ready?
I will, yeah. Yeah, so you won't have to keep on checking just to see if it's there. So the last thing I want to cover in chapter 4 is the composition of any point on the linkage. Today is the 27th, is that correct? So this is what this looks like. Here up to here, where A is. And then from here up to here, B is. So then we have this line here. Here's the
do the angles matter?
What I'm drawing here?
Yeah.
No. Yes, so you take from AB, the line AB, define delta 3. That is the angle between AB and AP. Okay? So if we look at this, this is RA. This here is R from A to P, RPA. That's this vector here. Therefore, this vector right here is R. RP equals RA plus RPA. All right? So if I want to, I could write this as, we know that this distance here is A, so we could write this as, and this angle here is theta 2. So I can write that A e to the j theta 2 plus little p e to the j delta 3 plus theta 3. Because this angle right here, I know, defines this angle right here is theta 3. Okay?
So is the RPA the same thing as the lowercase p?
The RPA, the distance of RPA is p. So now, I can write this thing saying that RP equals A cosine theta 2 plus J sine theta 2 plus P cosine, and I'm going to swap these, theta 3 plus delta 3, plus J sine theta 3 plus delta 3. So if I write the x component, That is of point P, that is A cosine theta 2 plus P cosine theta 3 plus delta. And if I do the y component, I get A sine theta 2 plus P sine theta 3 plus delta. Therefore, RP equals A cosine theta 2 plus P cosine theta 3 plus delta 3 plus J A sine theta 2 plus P sine theta 3 plus delta. Right. What we do is we use this to trace a point on the coupler. All right. So once you do this, you're able to locate a point on the coupler, and as that crank is moving around, you can actually see what that coupler point is doing. And that's helpful, say if you are trying to grab something and repeat that motion. Like on the old Polaroid cameras, they have a bunch of, you know, Polaroid cameras where you hit the button and it spits out and then you flop the film until it develops, and a minute later you see the picture. They have a bunch of four bars in those things. So if you smash one, you'll see a bunch of four bars. Okay. And what it does is it's grabbing stuff. And so they use a coupler point to like grab something and repeat it. So that's one place I actually see it. There's actually a story I'll share with you sometime about visiting Polaroid when they were making these. So that is the position of any point on a linkage. That concludes really chapter 4 for us. Questions on this before we talk about the exam? All right, so on the exam, I've posted last semester's exam on Blackboard. I also posted an exam on study guide. So let's go through some of these. So the exam is on Monday. And again, we'll try and get that homework back to you as soon as possible. No smartphones are allowed. I suggest that you bring a centimeter scale, a protractor, a compass, and in parentheses, I suggest, so that's suggesting, sheets of tracing paper, a triangle for constructing parallel lines, colored pencils if you wish. And I say do not bring cell phones. Don't use your cell phone. You know you can't go with that cell phone for a full hour and 15 minutes. But don't bring cell phones, tablets, or computers. No electronic PDF versions of the book are allowed. So don't come here and say, hey, all I have is my book on my computer or my tablet. I won't let you use it. No sharing of textbooks are allowed. So, you know, I think that should be an obvious one, but I've actually had to tell people, and they were shocked. What do you mean we can't share the textbook? So, can't share textbooks. Calculators are supposed to be non-modified calculators. Exam is open book, open notes. The topics are degrees of freedom analysis, Gruber's equation, graphical synthesis, the stuff that we're gonna do. You can notice how I did this right here. All right, you don't get that one. And then complex number notation, vector representation and addition, ATNQ function. If you ask me what that is that quadrant sensitive inverse tangent function that we talked about. So look for those notes on that. Okay? Then the position analysis, graphical four-bar, graphical crank slide, analytical four-bar, analytical crank slide, and position of any point on linkage, which we just covered. And I'll do an example of that if you want from the old exam. You want me to do that today. Any questions on what's going to be covered on the exam?
Can we use our homework?
Oh yeah, you can bring in your homework. Yep. Mm-hmm. Open book, open notes. Yeah. Okay. So I did bring the old exam in case you want me to work one or two questions off of it.
Are you going to post that study guide?
This study guide is okay. But if I do any problem on this exam, I do not post the solution. All right. So if you want the solution to one of these, ask me in class now, and I'll show you the solution. Do you want me to do any of the problems on the old exam?
The one that people miss the most.
I don't know what that one is.
I had Patrick's
a little fast.
Quick over to
the next points. What's that?
60 points.
This one right here. That one. Yeah, okay. Okay, so on this one here,
this is the same one.
This is how I would do it. I would bring some tracing paper. And I'll tell you one thing too. If on the exam you're getting stuff where you're drawing off the page, like I said before, you're doing something wrong. Alright? I designed the exams by the release so that you're not drawing off the page. So if you're drawing off the page, that's an immediate red flag that, hey, I'm doing something wrong. So what you do is you take, here's O2, here's O4, here's C2, here's D2. Right. You take that and you move it to the first position. That's my first position. Now what you do is you note where O2 and O4 are. And what I like to do on this is let the pen bleed through. So this right here is O2 prime, and this right here is O4 prime. So you get that. Alright? Then we take and do it for the third position. So the third position, you have C3 here and D3 here. And then we move that to the first position. And we poke through. And that becomes O2 double prime, and that's O4 double prime. Okay? We then take, we know that this right here is O2 and this is O4. We take and join the O2s. So we get from O2 to O2 prime. And O2 prime to O2 double prime. Then we go ahead and find the perpendicular bisector for this. And that location is G. In fact, it's G1. All right? So now we do the same thing for O4 to find H1. So O4 is O4 prime. This is perpendicular here. So this is where H1 is. All right. So then you draw a line for the first position.